Welcome to this spoken tutorial on user registration in DSpace. In this tutorial, we will learn to register a user in DSpace, cross-verify user registration, edit user profile, and distinguish between different users in DSpace. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04, DSpace version 6.3, and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other web browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have installed DSpace 6.3 on your system. Tomcat server should be running. A working internet connection should be available. Configured email settings in DSpace. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. Let us understand the different user roles in DSpace. DSpace has the following user roles: administrator, anonymous, e-person, community administrator, collection administrator, submitter, and reviewer. We will learn about these roles in detail later in this tutorial. First, let us proceed for user registration in DSpace. Open a web browser. In the address bar, type localhost:8080 and press enter. In the DSpace interface, click on the sign on to tab at the top right corner. Select My DSpace from the drop-down. In the Login to DSpace section, click on New User. Click here to register. This will take us to the user registration page. Type a valid email ID in the email address field. For this demonstration, I will type dspace.u2@gmail.com. Then click on the register button in the user registration form. If the email ID is valid, then we get a message, registration email sent. Before creating an account, DSpace verifies the email ID. Now, let us proceed for email verification. Open a new tab in the web browser. Log in to the email account which you used for the registration. I will log in to the mail account dspace.u2@gmail.com. In the inbox, locate the mail with the subject DSpace account registration. It may take some time to get a DSpace account registration email. If you can't find the mail in the inbox, you can check in the other mail folders. Open the DSpace account registration email. The account registration mail contains a registration link. You will receive a different token number in the registration link as compared to mine. Click on the registration link provided in the email. If you are accessing DSpace from a remote machine, type the remote machine IP instead of the local host. The registration information form opens in the DSpace interface. The fields marked with an asterisk are mandatory. I have typed the values for first name and last name as Pankaj Patil. Leave the field contact telephone as blank and keep the value for the language field as English. Next, we have to set a password for the user Pankaj Patil in the password field. I will type U2Pass. The length of the password must be at least 6 characters long. Retype the same password in the field again to confirm. Once you have filled the form, click on the Complete Registration button. If the form is filled correctly, we will get a message, Registration complete. The user is now successfully registered in DSpace. Let us try to log in with the newly registered user. Click on Sign On to tab at the top right corner. Select My DSpace from the drop-down. Login to DSpace form opens. Type the email address and password for the newly registered user, that is Pankaj Patil. And then click on the login button. My DSpace page appears. That means the user registration in DSpace is successful. DSpace offers the edit profile feature to all registered users. Let us proceed to edit the profile of user dspace.u2@gmail.com. At the top right corner, click on the drop-down next to the text logged in as dspace.u2@gmail.com. Then select Edit Profile from the drop-down. Edit Your Profile page appears. The user can edit first name, last name, contact telephone, password, etc. Let me update the last name as shown. Ensure that all the details are correct. Then click on the Update Profile button at the bottom of the page. On successful updation, we will get a message, Profile updated. Let us log out this user from the DSpace interface. So far, we have successfully registered a user and edited his profile. By default, all the users who are registered in DSpace are assigned to the role ePerson. ePerson is a registered user of DSpace. ePerson can view items which are published publicly, can upload items in the authorized collection, can also be assigned some other roles in DSpace. For example, administrator, community administrator, collection administrator, submitter, and reviewer. Anonymous users are not registered users in DSpace. They can view items which are published publicly, but they cannot upload items, and they don't have any authority in DSpace. Administrator users can manage ePersons, communities, collections, items, and other administrative activities. Community administrator manages the authorized communities in DSpace. Collection administrator manages the authorized collections in DSpace. Submitter can upload items in the authorized collections. And reviewer can review the items in the authorized collections. We will be learning more about these roles in later tutorials. With this, we come to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to register a user in DSpace, cross-verify user registration, edit user profile, and distinguish between different users in DSpace. As an assignment, register 2 new users with unique email IDs in DSpace. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and video for this tutorial were contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. This is Nancy Varkey signing off. Thank you for joining.